Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're in the studio with an Israeli-Australian composer whose name is Yitzhak Yedid. Welcome to the studio.
Thank you.
And to Melbourne.
Thank you for having me.
I just met you on Saturday night at Shelley Freeman's birthday party. And Jana said, you've got to have this guy on The Shtick. And I said, who is he? So now I've done a little bit of research on you, and I think you definitely have a shtick happening.
I believe so.
Yeah. You're originally from Jerusalem.
Correct.
And you studied music there.
Yeah.
At which academy?
I studied at the Rubin Academy in Jerusalem.
Which is highly acclaimed, of course.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's a good place.
I know. And as soon as you graduated from there, you went straight to Boston, Massachusetts.
Correct. At the New England Conservatory.
Fantastic. And you studied with a fellow called Paul Blay.
Yes, Paul Blay was the teacher I went to study. He was he died last year, was very famous pianist of improvised music. Most people know Keith Jarrett, but for me, Paul Blay is like Keith Jarrett.
He's, he was more classical though. He wasn't as commercial.
No, he wasn't as commercial, but he was an amazing improviser. I have lots of stories if you want me to tell you about his philosophy, which now I share with him. So
what's in a nutshell?
Look, Paul Blay was about, it was about doing it, not about talking about it. So a short story, once I came to the first lesson, he would tell me, Yitzhak, let's get a coffee. And I came to the second lesson, he told me, okay, let's get a coffee. And 3 weeks after it go on, I said to him, Paul, like, I'm here to take lessons from you. And he said, I said, you know what, let's come and play. So we played the duet and he didn't want to play basically. He told me, you know what, let's just do a recording. And he invited me to a recording. He wanted to play, he wanted to do it, not to talk about it.
Yeah, he was very, very talented in the improvisation field. Because that's, to me, jazz, when I watch jazz, and I've had lots of experience watching jazz, because I can't play it, you know, because you've got to be such a fine musician to be able to just play without notes, without, and it's all about feeling. And that's what you have. And you're a composer.
Yes.
And also a pianist.
Correct.
As well as that, you're an academic.
Correct.
And you've been living in Brisbane. How long have you been living in Brisbane?
That was 11 years.
11 years? Yeah. That's why we haven't heard of you, because no one knows anything about Brisbane. Because I know there is a Jewish, hello everyone in the Jewish community in Brisbane, like the three of you. do you have any involvement with the community there?
Oh, definitely. I performed in many of the events, Yom HaShoah, many events of the Jewish community, but I also performed here in Melbourne many times.
Yes.
Yes.
Whereabouts?
For example, at the Australian National Academy of Music at South Melbourne Town Hall.
Yes.
And
the Recital Centre.
Yes, and at the International Jazz Festival.
Oh, right. You were telling me. You're playing with the Ethiopian fellow.
Yes, Abate Berihun. It was very exciting. It's basically improvisation into jazz, Jewish music, integrations of styles, which is what I love doing.
And he's an Ethiopian Jew.
He's a Ethiopian Jew.
And what does he play?
He is a vocalist and plays the saxophone as well.
Saxophone. Yeah. That'd be amazing. The saxophone with the piano.
Yeah.
Sensational. Now, the thing I really was interested in was your shtick about combining Arabic and Jewish music. Tell us about that.
Well, that's interesting how I got into it, because when I went to the Rubin Academy, I started learning the piano and composition, and I really didn't feel that's really what I am. And I started, they just opened a new department of traditional Arabic music, and I started to realize that I can recognize what's called the makamat, the Arabic model system. Mm-hmm. And then I thought that that's actually the music I grew up upon.
Yes.
Because when I was a child, my father used to take me to hear the bakashot, that's singing before the service. And it's basically choirs, two choirs. People get together.
This is in synagogue?
This is in synagogue, yes. But it's people come for the music. It's not part of the service. So it starts at 2 a.m. and it goes until the dawn. Yeah.
Wow.
It's crazy. It is. And then they come and sing. So that's my first musical experience.
And where were your parents from?
My parents were born in Israel, but before that, for my mother's side, it's Iraqi.
Yeah.
For
and
my
Syrian.
Father's side, it's Syrian.
Oh,
yes.
Right.
So it's a Syrian tradition.
True Sephardic.
And yeah. That's what where I got the, you know, passion to integrate because I the East and the West, because I felt that this is really what I love hearing. It's in my DNA. It doesn't mean I don't like other styles, but it's something I feel for. So, so integrating Arabic music in general and Arabic Jewish music, basically.
Because that's the way to bring peace into the Middle East, really.
Yes, the peace is between people, and yes, culture is where you do. And I can tell you that between in the music community, there is peace between the nations.
Absolutely.
And between traditions. The one good thing about music, there are no borders. Anyone can play whatever music. I can play Jewish music, I can play Arabic music, I can play Indian music, I can play whatever I want, and people will welcome it.
You're speaking my language. Now, I have to tell the audience that we have to congratulate you on winning the Azrieli Prize for Jewish music, which was just announced this week.
Yes, correct.
Yes? And it's a fantastic, and you have already won several prizes, which will include the Prime Minister's Prize in Israel.
Yes, correct.
Yes? And you also won the Landau Prize?
Correct.
Yes. And you won the Sydney, you are actually a Sidney Myer Creative Fellow.
Yes.
So you are highly credentialed, and that's one of the reasons I have to introduce you to people in the world of Shtick, because you certainly have, and I'd love to keep on going. We'll have you back when you come back to Melbourne to talk a little bit more about what you do. But in this instance, we're on the Shtick, and we're going out now with a little bit of the music that you won the prize for, which is called Kiddushim Ve Killulim.
Ve Killulim. Blessing and curses.
That's it. And this is a little excerpt from the music that you composed that won the Azrieli Prize, which is sensational. Thank you.
Thank you.
So much for coming into the studio.
Thank you.
We'll be back next week with more Shtick. We'll be right back.